3-point take down, missing.
Good job, Salvante! Great job!
Three near falls, missing.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Three-point takedown.
Get one, two, three. And we're out.
Hey, great job.
Three.
On for the state, Virginia.
Head up. Go Terps. Go now. Go. Hands in the rear neck. Test it. Yes. Go on. Yes. Head up.
That's short time.
Double.
Three, two, one.
One point escape, Michigan.
Yep, stay up.
Michigan 11, UVA 3. Now for 174 pounds for Michigan, Joseph Warner. Happy for the Cavaliers, Rocco Pontillo.
Thank you.
3-point near fall this year. One for this game, Cavaliers.
Back on.
University of Virginia hosting the University of Michigan from Mem Gym. Looks like we got a presentation here of an amazing patriotic singlet brought to you by University of Virginia Nike. Steve Garland wearing the military-themed UVA shirt. So far, first three matches, 157, 165, 174, all major decisions for Michigan. 157. We started off with Chase Saldate, then we had Mantinona, we just had Joe Walker. So it is 12-0, three matches in from Mr. UVA needs something to go right here. Cantino started off good, and then it went sort of all the other way for Joe Walker. Neither one of these guys are ranked right now in the top 33. And we'll wait for that clock to run down in 4, 3, 2, 1, and then we'll get started. Ready to go. Lots of hand fighting early here. Gamble's doing a good job of trying to hold center of the mat. And you're the underdog, sometimes just winning the early hand fight and not giving up anything early is a good way to build confidence. Seconds down, no real leg attacks yet. Both guys with that right leg lead, both guys trying to get inside the tie-ups, not outside the tie-ups, which they've been taught that by the best coaches from the time they were little till now. Inside hand fight, pulling on that guy's head and neck, getting him tired. That's gonna always be a core staple of wrestling. Over a minute down yet. Referee's letting him wrestle. Good snap there by Gamble. Good high crotch position. Changes it to a head inside single, tree tops it. Really nice run out by Bullock, and that's one that got away from Virginia there. That was a great shot. Really nice finish, and it kind of looked like Bullock was going to get. Bullock just slipped. And nice go behind by Gamble. He's up 3-0, looked like a little quick attempt on a reversal. And now, this position we've seen all night is this quad pod. Michigan did a way, way better job of getting pressure on the guy's top half and keeping him from being able to get to his feet. Only 11 seconds of riding time for Gamble, but does score the first takedown. So he's up 3-1 with 1:05 and counting. He's in again on a shot. Good hips by Bullock here. Doesn't look like either one of them are going to try to improve. We're going to get a stalemate right at 1 minute. Gamble's firing off shots. Excuse me, that's something you want to see if you're a coach. Got the hand fight and the finger locks going. Blast double by Bullock. Hips back by Gamble. Both these guys are letting it rip, which is what you want to see. Now a good shot by Bullock. So this is the difference in matches. You get your leg, you get his leg up, I get his leg up. We see who wins these positions. Bullock was able to defend Gamble, so if he can go the other way, it's even. Now he's got it shelved. And this is where he turned down and gave up the takedown. And 10 seconds left in the period. So if he doesn't get away, that's the difference. Really good patient finish by Bullock. Gamble's got to go hard here. It's basically he should be the only one that can score inside of 10 seconds from the bottom. The referee was out of the shot, but it sure looks like he gave a caution on top. Gamble's got to go quick here. Trying to be explosive. Bullock with double spikes. Keeping him on one knee. That's the end of the period. So the riding time's dead even. The difference is the escape. I would think, yeah, Bullock will go down first. You would expect that if you didn't get rode hard the first time, you get a chance to extend your lead. Psychologically, that's a good move. And then if for any reason you're down in the third period, you can kick the guy loose. You don't have to work to get it moving. He's out fast in 6 seconds, 5-3 in favor of Bullock. But Gamble's in this match. He's had some good moments. He's driving here. Bullock did a good job of turning and getting himself facing out. Nice little shallow level fake there by Gamble. Had Bullock off balance a little bit. Didn't stay with it, but really had something. Hopefully he felt that and will be able to get back to it if you're a UVA fan. We're down to 1:10 in the period. Pace has slowed considerably. Now Gamble starting to pick up his hand fight, his head snap. A lot of takedowns just come late because one person wore down the other person. Down to 45 seconds. Good shot by Bullock, double leg. Ran through him nice. This is that part where it's like Bullock's not stalling, but he's also not trying to score. He's trying to kill the clock, kill the period, so it gets a little tricky. Hey, 20 seconds left on the restart, 8-3 Bullock. Gamble will have choice next period, but again, like, you know, if he had gotten out at the end of the first period, it'd be 8-4. If he could get out now, it'd be 8-5. And then you get out next period, it's 8-6. These little end of period sequences are super important to either winning or staying in matches. Bullock does a good job of staying with them, down to 9 seconds. One more restart. Quad pop again. Goes to that little half switch. We've seen a couple of the UVA guys do that. And Bullock's gonna ride out the period. I think Gamble will go down again. There hasn't been any danger from Bullock to turn him. And that's what he does do. Good shot. quad pot again. Trying to probably get that knee slide if he can. Bullock's hooking that inside leg. Probably going to try to get to the riding time run up. The riding time's just about at a minute. And those two non-escapes are a big difference. It goes from, realistically, Gamble being able to win the match, Bullock just got hit on top for stalling, to Michigan now realistically looking for bonus. It's D, so it's a 5-point spread. And he's got riding time, so a 6-point spread. If he gave up an escape, it's 5. And if he gets a takedown and can finish on top, he'd have a major. Hard mat return there by Bullock. Okay, Gamble's out, so it's 8-4. 1 minute to go. Riding time's at 122. Gamble needs feet to back, and he can win this match. And then if not, then Bullock can get a takedown for the major, or they just hold it out and it's a decision. Down to 40 seconds. Bullock's taking more of the shots than Gamble is at this point. Down to 15 seconds here. If you're coaching Gamble, you really want to see him fire something off, like try to go for it. There, that's what you want to see. Nice shot, leg in the air. Oh, that's twice he's let him out of it. Now Bullock's going to try to get that double. They both flurried hard at the end here. Final score 9-4. That makes the team score 15-0.
Final score, Michigan 8-4.
Okay, the highest ranked wrestler in the meet here is Jacob Cardenas for the University of Michigan. He's going to be taking on Ethan Weatherspoon from the University of Virginia. Weatherspoon 0-0 this year, 15-29 in his career, so a significant underdog. Cardenas is ranked number 3 in the country by Intermat and is a multiple-time All-American, transferred over from Cornell University, multiple-time age group world team member. Just really, really high level wrestler, gets the first takedown, and he's not afraid to go to work on top. He's a high pressure guy on the ground as well. Cardenas is a Bergen Catholic wrestler. I actually got to see him wrestle in high school at the Oak Park River Forest Duels. The Beat the Street Chicago Duels, part of that crew with Robbie Howard and a bunch of those other studs. That was a squad for sure. Weatherspoon gets the escape. Looks like he got poked in the eye. Certainly wasn't intentional. Referee's gonna let him get his headgear and eyes right. We're back at it. 21 seconds on the riding time on the first takedown for Cardenas. Happened again. The slower the pace, the less amount of scrambles, probably better for Weatherspoon. Cardenas wants to keep that match high volume wrestling and get that good level change, especially for a big guy. Down to 1:15 in the period. Pace is really, really slowed down now.
Keep your feet up.
Yeah, good double leg here. Oh my goodness, Weatherspoon came out the back for a second. And then Cardenas settled back, got to a headlock. That is tight. He's got 3 and 4. And then Weatherspoon really battled hard to get off his back. Looks like he's gonna at least get an escape. This is smart by Cardenas, because if he stays here, it's a stalemate and he's back on top. Okay, so that was 3-1, plus 3 for the takedown, plus 4 for the near fall, so 10-1 is correct. With the new takedown rules and the new near fall rules, you can run up scores quick with feet to back moves. ...25 seconds left in the period. Gonna see if we can get a ride out here. If you're Michigan, certainly trying to get at least an escape if you're Weatherspoon. And that's gonna be the period. 10-1, really, really good period for Cardenas, although that's what you would expect. And over a minute of riding time. Cardenas will choose down. If you're new to college wrestling, 15 points is a tech fall. They will stop the match. And again, the riding time point doesn't count towards that. Cardenas with a false start, then the respectful pat on the shoulder to Weatherspoon to give him room to come back to starting position. Great, great stand up out in probably 4 seconds. It's at 11-1. A takedown and any sort of back points would be a tech fall. Weatherspoon, this is just when you're outmatched, it's just about being tough and not conceding anything, trying to take ground, do what you can, work for your attacks. But that's nice what he tried to do there. Good go behind defense or offense, excuse me, counterattack by Cardenas. It's 14-1. He can either work for a turn, which he's got. He's got that cross rails tilt. He's gonna go ahead in the hole again, try to catch him on the way through. He's got the tech fall at least, and that'll be it. I don't know how many points they gave. They gave 4. So it's gonna be 18-1. I do not know if we're stopping halfway, folks. That was the 5th match, so we will see if the heavyweights come right out. Looks like they are. So it's gonna be Gabe Christian from UVA. Let me pull up Gabe's information here. He is 1-0 this year, 15-12 in his career. Let's see if we can find out. He beat Drew Blackburn 9-1 for North Dakota State. And he is going to be taking on. I do not know. There's a bunch of heavyweights here. Might be Lance Trost. Might be Keegan Nugent. Might be Zabriel Kershidov. So if anybody knows, or maybe even Ira Jenkins, that'd be great. Otherwise, we're just gonna call him Michigan. Josh Heinzelman, the OU transfer, will wrestle for Michigan's second semester. And he is a high quality wrestler, multiple time NCAA qualifier. He's currently ranked 12th in Intermat. Team score all Michigan right now, 20-0. Wearing sort of that semi-tight tie. There's a lot of pummeling going on. Nice attempt by Christensen. Now we're in that ear-to-ear battle. Christensen's a senior. Got lots of paper here, folks, trying to make sure we can get you everything. Oh, nice snap down by Christensen. Halfway through the first period, no score, no stalls, no cautions. Down to a minute 15. Gabe Christensen's putting that work in, getting those guys snapped. And it feels like eventually that's gonna pay off for him. Every time you make somebody take a heavy step, every time you get their neck and lower back tired, you're hoping that pays dividends. Now we're in the over-under. There was a warning against Michigan. Low shoulder wins in these positions, folks. Whoever got the low shoulder, it's not the lock. Christensen felt like he had the low shoulder and changed to the high crotch. Cuts across, gets the kick out. Really nice. Took him out of bounds. Clock stopped. Steve Garvin is fired up, folks. Just ran over there and gave him a pat on the tuchus. 3-0, 30 seconds to go in the period. Christensen took the risk, took the shot. A lot of times you don't want a heavyweight to hit his knee, but he just hit it, popped right up, was really well done. Gonna try to finish here, keep him down. 24 seconds here left in the period. Breakdown by Christensen, and it sure looks like he's going to ride out the period, which is what we saw happen by the Michigan guys. That's just winning wrestling right there. He is going to ride out the period. It's going to be 3-0, 36 seconds of riding time. Michigan is going to pick Town. Think of your Christensen, you're trying to ride at least to get to the riding time. Michigan wrestler doing a good job of working up, working hard. Now he's out, 3-1, 50 seconds of riding time, and Christensen will have Choi's next period. Be interesting to see how he approaches that. This looks a lot like the first period, folks. A lot of ear to ear, a lot of pulling, hanging on the guy's head, trying to get him worn out. And they're both setting up a shot, not working too hard, too indiscriminately, just shooting for the sake of shooting. Everything's gonna be structured. Down to a minute in the period. Now Christensen's got that underhook, which he likes. That's where the high crotch is gonna come from. He wants his left side underhook and have his attack hand, his right hand ready to go. There's a snap again. Down to 35 seconds in the period. It's always a fun, stark change to go from 285 back down to 125, but that's what's gonna come next. Another good shot by Christensen. Gonna try to run the pipe. Sometimes that's a bad idea because you put the guy's foot on the ground. That's what happened in this case. Oh, now an inside trip attempt by Michigan. But again, low shoulder. Christensen had the low shoulder, so that made it a lot easier. Christensen will choose down, so it's gonna be 3-1, 50 seconds of riding time going into the third period. Leg comes in for Michigan, power half. Christensen could be in a good position to reverse here. Michigan wants to climb their hips up. Christensen wants to stay here and get his leg out. and hip heist. Get his hips above. Scramble, get his chest to the mat. Get out of his lap. He's broke the leg lock now and back to it. He had it broke for a second. One escape. No riding time. 1:20 to go. He gave the escape the wrong way, so it should be 4-1, not 3-2. Shot here by Michigan. Christensen's keeping him just squared up out in front. Garland's going over to make sure the score is right. Been in that position, even though they say we got it, we got it. You want him to go get it. It is 4-1, they do have it correct. There will be no riding time in this match, so a takedown by Michigan and a ride out would get them to overtime. The only other way to win is to go feet to back here. Shot, good sprawl by Christensen. Hips heavy. And he's comfortable just being here. He doesn't need to score. So he's fine with this. 21 seconds. He's done a lot of work. He doesn't have to attack here, folks. Nice shot. Goodness, that was fast. Really good shot. He's in the waterfall position. Trying to either get the neutral danger takedown or the takedown takedown. And he's got a hustle. Christensen does a nice job of getting this guy up. And stay right there. Which he will do for the home. Big win for Virginia. Crowd is excited. Need to get them on the board. Stop the bleeding. Those are the first three team points, excuse me, for Virginia. So we're going to go back down to 125. See who we have here. Can't tell who this is from Michigan. I believe it's Teddy Flores from Parkridge, Illinois. Main South High School taking on Kevion Roller. Roller is 2-0 this season, 15-9 in his career. Pull up his results, his wins so far this season. He beat Tristan Dougherty of North Dakota State 4-2, beat Tyler Washburn of Citadel 15-8. He's in on a single early. He's got the leg in the air. Goes to the head, nice takedown. Sometimes you want your guys to break their grip on that, but if you can get it, you can get it. He is a sophomore. Not sure if this is Flores. This might be Nolan Wertanen, I think is how you pronounce his name. Wertanen is how it's pronounced. So I think that's who we're going to go with. Let me see if I can pull up his information. Got an escape and another double leg by Roller. He's getting after it. Wertanen's from St. Joe, Michigan, academic All Big Ten and Big Ten Distinguished Scholar. Took fifth at the Cleveland State Open. Three Michigan State titles, first three-time state champ in the school's history. Escape for him, make it 6-2. 13-8 overall, 2-1 in duels, 11-7 tournaments, 4 falls, 3 techs, 2 majors. 6-2, 2 escapes, 2 takedowns. Minute and a half to go in the first period.
Come on, come on, come on.
Good shot. And right, my goodness, Roller is fast. Really nice with the end there. I don't know if you're him, if you don't want to just have him cut him loose and try to get one more and get to the major before the end of the period. Big mat return. Big mat return. 9-2 right now. Creeping up on a minute of riding time and creeping down to 50 seconds left in the period. They're wrestling here on the edge, folks. Anything in is in. Michigan wrestler stuck his hand on the mat to stay in. Got the escape. Roller shot him off. Action call. 9-3, 1:18 of riding time. Yeah, they called him up. He doesn't know he's got an escape. Oh, no, they didn't call him up. Well, wait a minute. Then it should be 9-2. And you got to change the scoreboard to 9-2, folks. It looked like he gave an escape. I wonder if Coach Formette will challenge this. They're going to go back and review this themselves. So right now they took the escape off, so it's 9-2. So they can either leave it that way and then they start in top and bottom, or they give the escape and they start neutral. It's one or the other. We saw this last night. It was at the Iowa State-Iowa meet, and there was a challenge from both sides on a call, and the initial decision by the referees were to have both sides take their bricks back and they would just review it themselves. If you're not used to college wrestling, it is sort of like international wrestling in that you get a brick to challenge calls. It is different on how many lost bricks you can have before you run out. In international, it's generally by the match. In college, it's by the event, by either the dual meet or the tournament. Okay, so they decided, well, they're on their feet, so it should say 9-3. There we go, we got it. Okay, 30 seconds to go. Kevon looks ready. He looks like he might try to get another one this period. Fifteen seconds left in the period here. Might be wrong, looks like. Nope, I was right, he's gonna shoot. He's to the body, he's got a lift. Oh my goodness, nice counter. Really good by both guys. That's a lot of action for no points, but really well done. Roller is gonna choose down. 1:18 on the riding time clock. Gets to that quad pod. Everybody's quad pod these days. If you're coaching in high school, you got to teach quad pod, not just stand or stand up. Well, that was really well done by the ref. He was watching it. He had that arm on the back and didn't like how it looked and got himself right in there. And this is always a difficult decision if you're like the Coach Garland side of things, because Kevon Roller was completely controlling the match on his feet, and now he's put himself and the opponent where the other guy was out of his best position. He got an escape, but he lost the riding time in the process and might have taken a little starch out of him. You have to decide. It's also early in the year, and you're working on making sure you can get your escape, so that's usually the mindset of the coach. If this was the last match of the duel and they needed a tech, I think he probably chooses neutral. Oh my gosh. Good go behind by Roller. And it looked like Rotanen was going to try for a headlock there. And Roller actually ducked underneath it. So now it's up to 13-3. The riding time is climbing. Looking for that suck back. He gets away where Tannen does. It was 13-4. Down to 30 seconds in the period. These guys wouldn't be surprised to see one more big flurry. We're tanning with a little half shot. Roller's really fast, guys. He's got really nice feet. Kind of got to tighten a few things up, but he does a lot of things really well. Tannen will go down. It's 13-4, so the escape doesn't change the major. Tannen right to his feet. Now to a sit position. Roller trying to get back pressure on him. Escape for Tannen. Now it's 13-5. Riding time's at a minute 20. The riding time does not matter for a roller at this point. He's already got a major. Takedown and any back points would be at least 5, and that would get him a lot closer. Little shrug by attempt. Tannen with a good deep step fake. Down to 110 in the period. And Roller has not decided to let it rip yet. He's done a lot of offense this match, but not so much this period. Where Tannen feels like he's trying to pick his spots. Roller's feet are so nice, it's hard for you to find him. It feels like you're off. Oh my goodness, these fakes are so nice. The snaps go behind. He's in on the double. Boy, Tannen did a really nice job of hipping out of that double. Such a good scramble. That is a massive exertion of energy by both guys. Down at 35 seconds. A big feet to back would get Roller the tech. And against a guy like Tannen, who's actually going to try to win the match, that's way more likely than a guy who stalls. And that's a credit to Tannen for in here trying to scrap and not just sit on it. We're to the body, folks. Change to a single. Tannen, instead of sprawling, bumps into Roller, which is nice, then squares up. Now he's in short offense, tried to do a knee tap, dresser dump sort of situation there. Roller got out of it. Tannen tried to go underhook to his back. And that was the final. Roller celebrating. Final score 14-5. Deer scores 20-7. Dylan Ragusan up next for Michigan. Absolute stud, graduate student, All-American. Montini Catholic in Illinois. He's going to take on Gable Porter, who is 2-0, 12-5 in his career. Porter's ranked number 32. He's a freshman from Iowa. Ragusan's ranked number 4. A lot of people remember his interview after his match with Dayton Fix last year. Gable Porter's in right away. He ain't wrestling scared. Like to see it. Ragusan tried to do the pinch. Porter's got him in the waterfall position. Ragusan's got ankles. Porter gets him elevated again. He's trying to windshield wiper himself. It's going to probably be a stalemate. Porter's trying to turn into it. If he can shelf the foot, he'd be good. Ragusan's got near ankle. Trying to pin it to his butt. Can't take it out past the joint. They're gonna stop. You can't pull that down there. That should be stopped. It's gonna be a stalemate. What a great first minute of wrestling, folks. No scoring, but great scrapping. If Ragusan thought he was gonna lay down, yeah, but Porter came to scrap. Good snap by Ragusan. Really, really good snap. Cable Porter with lefty underhook. Ragusan going spike on the defense, comes right out to a reshot, reattack. She liked to see guys wrestling out of every position. Now Porter's got a pretty good front headlock position here. Ragusan's trying to control the hand. Nice dummy drag. It's exactly what you could tell he was setting that up. I couldn't get it out quick enough. Really well done. He's gonna try to suck him back. Goes head in the hole. Leg across here. Cable Porter gets himself out of bounds, gets the restart, which is what you want in that position because you're not gonna score. Big fan of Ragusan, how he carries himself. He's another one of those guys, was at those Beat the Street Chicago duels. Part of those Izzy Martinez, Mikey Benefield led Montini Catholic teams. He's to his feet, Porter is. If he can stay up here, he can get a stall call. Nice mat return by Ragusan. Sit back tilt, now he's got it, gonna go ahead in the hole with it. This tilt, like five, eight, 10 years ago, has become the thing. Instead of the reinforced one, now it's over the top, head in the hole. You can roll through with it or suck him back into you. Now riding time is at a minute, 20 seconds left in the period. Gable Porter has urgency. Just Ragusan's good. He's good in every position, including the top position. That's how you become a top four guy in the country. That's how you become an All-American, not having any holes in your game. And 133 is fairly wide open, folks. We've already seen Drake Ayala, who is the runner-up at 125, move up and take a loss. Nasser Bailey, who was the second highest returning All-American, lost in the All-Star meet to Lucas Bird. Lucas Bird is coming back after a redshirt year. Ryan Crookham is your number one guy. He took third at Nationals. The only guy he lost to was Vito Arujao, who won it, and he beat Vito during the regular season and at the EIWAs. So he's the favorite, but he's not Gable Stevenson favorite. He's, you know, those guys feel like they have a chance to beat him. Ragusan picks down. I think Gable's at least gonna try to kill this riding time. See how that goes here. He gets a lift. Ragusan gets out. 103 a riding time, still on the board. So Ragusan is up the takedown and the escape and the riding time right now. Down to a minute and a half. Nice little jab step by Ragusan there. Good snap. Attack to the other side. He's trying to find what's working and he's starting to find his rhythm, folks. Oh, as soon as I say that, Gable Porter hits a really nice high crotch, changes it to head inside single. He's got the lock below the ankle. He's trying to shelf it. Ragusan did that little shin, like that little limp leg to get out, tried to go reattack. Porter re-squared up. Now he's got Ragusan in front head. This is where Ragusan hit that dummy drag the last time. And do a little elbow pass to get out of it there as well. So really good wrestling for no points by both guys. Down to 20 seconds left in the period. 4-0 Michigan in the match. 27 Michigan, 22-7. Michigan in the duel. Good shot by Ragusan, end of period. This has been the difference all night between Michigan and Virginia. They score at the end of periods. And then they don't give back the escape or the reversal. So now it's 7-0 plus riding time, so it's 8-0. Porter will pick down. So for Ragusan to get a major, he's either ride him out, more likely cut him loose, try to get a takedown. If it goes real well, try to get multiple takedowns. He looked at the corner about freestyle start, that we couldn't see the corner on our camera angle, but they obviously told him to get on top of him because that's what he did. And sometimes coaches will have you work on different parts of your game. It was a nice tilt attempt there by Ragusan. Nice mat return to a Turk. Can trap that bottom shoulder. This is going to, he's going to get, oh wow. Porter did a really nice job getting his head up and getting out of it. Now, and this is tough for Porter here because he's actually still on bottom right now. It looks like a takedown position, but since he started on bottom, the riding time clock is running in favor of Ragusan. So we lost 50 seconds this period, nothing changed. We got a restart. Ragusan is gonna let him loose. 7-1, riding time is locked. So it's 8-1. Ragusan with a nice head and heel, ankle pick, low single, whatever you want to call it. He's got the double, and he's keeping the turn. He's gotten good at this. He did this to Dylan Shaver at NCAAs, who had teched him in the Big Ten Finals. This is a great ride, not only to ride, but for back points, but you don't get hit for stalling here because it's a pinning combination. And if you're the bottom guy, until you get your leg out of that turret, you're not getting away. This is gonna be the final, folks, 11-1. Good workmanlike victory for Ragusan. Michigan adds 4 to their team score, makes the score 24-7. Pounds. We have Kyron Butler from Virginia. Kyron is 2-0 this season, 25-18 in his career. He had a good win. He beat Kellen March from North Dakota State, who's ranked number 35-4. And then he beat Thomas Torini from the Citadel 4-1 in overtime. And this is going to be Sergio Lemley, who's ranked number 8 in the country. Stud. Actually beat Real Woods last year in the dual meet. Didn't have the NCAA tournament he wanted, but is somebody that you certainly think has the ceiling to place this year at the NCAAs. Lemley is a high output guy, high ceiling guy. Somebody that Sean Bormette and company worked hard to recruit. For people that do or don't know, Sean Bormette used to run the Overtime School of Wrestling in Chicago. I actually got a chance to corner Mikey Benefield with him when Mikey won University Nationals. So he has great connections with John Kading and all those folks up in Chicago. And that's obviously super helpful for recruiting, and recruiting is the lifeblood of a program. 1 minute down here. Good start for Kyron Butler, especially.
Go ahead, come
Wembley doing his best to get on his neck and get him tired. We're down to a minute 10. And then, like, again, for Kyron Butler, this is good, right? You're the underdog. The longer nothing goes against you, the more confidence you build. You're in the match points-wise. You're in the points match mentally. So a lot of things here that are to his advantage. Good shot by Butler. Lemley gets that leg back. Down to 30 seconds, folks. If you're coaching Lemley, you'd like to see him get to more offense, frankly. Hasn't pulled the trigger, certainly to the level that you'd like him to. First period's going to be scoreless. These guys are just exchanging email addresses to make sure everybody's got Christmas cards and Thanksgiving plans lined up. See who's going to pick down first. It's going to be Butler. Lemley's pretty good on top. Butler doesn't want to sit down here and let him get into that riding time game. That's not a position, especially when it was this even on his feet, and he might have even had a little better of it. Lemley with the mat return, Butler back to quad pod. Now he's to his feet. Like, this is, if you're Butler, you got to get out here. Now you got to get out of bounds and get a restart. Lemley's staying on as long as he can. 48 seconds of riding time. Got a leg in now. It's not super deep, but he's now crossed a minute of riding time. So now, even if Butler gets out, Lemley has a path to winning without a takedown. Super important you score first in the period of your choice. If that's not happening, you're probably not winning a lot of matches. Butler's to his feet. He's trying to run out of this. He's out. It looked like he got out. He got out at the 142 mark, 18 seconds left in the period. But he's still in this match. Don't want to take a stall call here. Keep yourself composed. Don't let anything crazy happen. And we're going to go to the third period. Lemley will choose down. He's got 42 seconds to get out. Caution on. That's the third caution? Wow. That's significant. If you don't ride them for any period of time and you just did that without putting a tough ride on them, see, that's silly. If you were going to do that, you just let him go. We literally saw that happen with Etchemendia and Parco last night, where Etchemendia scored the only takedown of the match and lost the match 4-3. Bowler's on his offense now, so it's 2-1 on the scoreboard, but the riding time is now cinched. Lemley with the go behind. They almost called neutral takedown, but they didn't. Lemley's trying to bump into Butler. Butler's trying to get a stalemate here. Okay, he's got a takedown and backwards. He just blew this match open. Wow, 3-4. Okay, so it was 0-1, then 1-1 on the penalty, 2-1 on the escape, 5-1 on the takedown, 9-1 on the near fall, plus the riding time. This match on the scoreboard is gonna look like, people are gonna look at the box score, oh my gosh, he's gonna get 4 more. So it's gonna be 13-1. They gave him 2 near fall, I think. So it's 15-1. This is crazy, folks. It was 0-0. I'm sorry, it was 1-0 for Virginia going in the third period. And if he rides out, he's gonna tech fall him. I don't think I've ever seen that. I've been watching wrestling a lot of years. That's crazy. Big lift by Lemley. Gets him down to the ground. There's two ways to talk to him about this as a coach. The sort of negative way is to say, you got to open up sooner. The positive way is to say, man, you really brought the whole kitchen sink in the third period. What a third period for Sergio Lemley. That's a tech fall for Michigan, and they add 5 more to the scoreboard. What an absolutely wild finish to that match.
For Michigan, Nathan Girard. And for the Cavaliers, Jack Geoffrey.
Okay, so this is the last match of the night, folks. This is Jack Geoffrey from Virginia. Jack is 0-0 this season, 18-19 in his career. And this should be Dylan Gilcher, but it may not be from Michigan. Let me see if we can figure out who this is. Want to thank the good folks at UVA for giving me this opportunity. Love watching University of Virginia wrestling, as well as any just high quality wrestling. And both these are top level programs run by good people, run the right way. Not only worried about winning wrestling matches, but developing high quality young men. Joffrey's in on leg attacks. Good takedown by Joffrey. I'm trying to look up who this is. This is either Gilcher or Justin Gates. So Michigan has clinched the duel, as I'm sure you guys understand. Joffrey's good ride out there to the side. He's working on that riding time.
Take
doing a good job here of building riding time and really smart on the edge where if you get in trouble, you can take him out of bounds. Wow, he almost let him go. That was a little crazy. As soon as I said that, I jinxed him. So 112 to go in the period, 58 seconds of riding time for Joffrey. Good forward pressure here by the Virginia wrestler. Oh, he's up. That back point, that's tight. He can swim over the head. He got three near fall. That makes it 6-0.
3-4 near fall, Virginia.
Down to 40 seconds in the period. He's working hard on top. That's what you like to see. Also, obviously, the timing of the starting, who's which started, is random. But if you have, you finish your match with a win, your dual team match is a win, that's something to build on. Gives the people in the gym something to go home happy about. Joffrey gets a whole first period ride, a takedown and near fall, and over 2 minutes of riding time. Michigan wrestler is gonna defer, which is a good choice. Joffrey's gonna go down. A conversation about starting position on bottom. There was a caution. Joffrey's to his feet. He's got good hand control. Oh, he was gonna go for a high flyer there, folks. Kicked out, got the escape. Oh my gosh, nice go behind too. Really nice, 1-3 right there. Just like that, it's 10-0. He's looking at the corner. He's gonna get physical with him, cut him loose. Got some blood on the mat. And then Joffrey said, both up. This is gonna be 10-1. Oh, wow, nice shot. Didn't catch the leg, but really nice shot through the window there. Another shot by Joffrey. You can tell he feels confident. He's not too worried about the defense of the Michigan wrestler. Down to a minute. Another shot. There's a stall call. That's well deserved. Joffrey's really working hard. Swing single by Joffrey, gets it a leg. The finish was a little easier than you might expect. 13-1. Twenty-five seconds left in the period. Looks like he'll ride him out. My guess is Michigan will pick down. This is probably Justin Gates. I've seen Dylan Gilcher wrestle. Gates is a freshman from Davidson, Michigan. if this is Gates. He was a three-time Michigan State champion. Did some nice growth. Won at his 103 as a freshman, 138 as a junior, 144 as a senior. Was second at 119 as a sophomore, 147-8. Career record, was part of two team champions. Enrolled in the School of Engineering. And was the Dave Schultz Excellence Award winner. It'll clean up in aisle two here. We're getting everything wrapped up. And we'll get back to the action here. Like for a second, I thought the Michigan wrestler was going to pick top, but nope, going to go down. Joffrey would just kick him loose. He essentially has a 12-point lead, so he needs two takedowns. Super interesting here. I'm surprised he has not cut him loose. I thought for sure that would be the path he would take. Any near fall would get him a tech because of the riding time point, but that's a stall call, so that's one. So now he just needs one takedown. Okay, there's the escape. You gotta go get it. Get the chant, the crowd, something to root for here. And he does. What a great way to end it for Virginia. The final dual meet score will be 29-12. Wanna wish everybody Happy Thanksgiving. Thank you so much to the University of Virginia folks, the ACC Network, and the University of Michigan. My name is David Mirakatani. Thank you guys for watching and listening. I am so-
அடி 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 எனக்கு மெட்டாமல் மனசில்லையோ